Oh my god, it's actually loud. Okay, it's time for another recording, and before this recording I already did edit all the previous episodes, so I can talk about things that I kinda missed and wanna talk about. So first thing that is a small detail that I noticed because I had to add the small bonus at the end of the third episode is the fact that the main character at the start of the game was looking happy in the main screen. Meanwhile, now she looks kind of concerned. So I wonder if it's related to your progress, like it was in Metal Unit, or is it something else? Because yeah, now right now we're kind of behind the time when it comes to the project, so I guess it makes sense why she would look concerned. But okay. First thing I want to do is... Where is... A while back, long ago. Okay, let's maybe go here. Oh, perfect, it is exactly where I wanted to be. Okay, so first thing I wanted to show is the fact that I was wrong, actually, which doesn't happen often. But Penny is actually shown with a suit in one part of this game, and that is the save file. If you look at the bottom left picture, she does wear a suit there. It's not her usual outfit, so that's pretty cool. It took me really long to notice that, but it's such a cool detail. And I just wanted to be here just to check the phone and ignore Miss Whiskey once again in the past, as I do. Okay, there are my two cats, Trumbles and Sniffs. To-do list. Survive first day of work. Orientation. Go to office. Recharge transit card. Finish comic. Buy new outfit. Finish new job paperwork. Do laundry. Jog. Clean up. And I finally realized that I'm pretty sure that apt just means... Oh no. Appointment, right. Almost forgot that one. Yeah, I think it just means appointment. But I had no clue the previous day, so I was like, okay, Trumbles apt. What is that? Okay, clean up. Clean up appointment. Huh. Call mom. Try that new dessert bakery. Wasn't it like 12 a.m. when she came here? How did she do all of these things today? Like, buy new outfit. Try that new bakery. Okay. I guess Penny was busy this week. First day at new work. Today. Trumbull's vet appointment. Tomorrow. Dinner with A. Interesting. Okay. I don't think I can call anyone right now. I wonder what would... Because maybe staying in your phone, totally fine. But if you go into this Lumberlust game, maybe that's when things hit the floor. I guess it's not set up yet. Whoopsie daisy, unable to load emails. I see this message every day. My work email. And if I sound weird today, it's because I was sleeping for like 5 hours. Oh, never mind, I was sleeping for 8 hours. Okay, the plan was to sleep 5 hours though. Okay, so let's go here. Okay, let me... What did I wanted to do? Oh, right. Let me just go into the main menu. Okay, so I mentioned that the project that we drew weren't related at all to the characters that we met. But actually, I was incorrect. When you look at this cabbage photo, you can see this humanoid character is the one that has these two green bits on its head. Exactly like cabbage, so I guess we are drawing the characters that inspire us. There's also the blue hair here. And I think Sky has short hair, but still, a blue hair on the humanoid character, which would suggest it's related. And last thing before starting the actual game, let me apologize, okay? One thing I messed up, I called Kini a cabbage. I'm sorry about that. I will fix that ASAP, okay? From now on, I'm not calling her cabbage anymore. Because that was very rude of me. She's gonna be called Cabby instead. Okay, so... I don't know, we can call Cabby, I guess. But I wanna check everything, because I'm pretty sure the option to rest eyes was already there before even exploring the place, so there is a possibility that I just missed something. Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. Okay, I did everything here. Let's go to the break room. I don't think I missed a lot of things, but maybe I missed one thing. And that would make me not too happy. Time to take a break in the break room. I think I'm done with coffee for tonight though. Okay, I guess there isn't anything to do. Go back to the main office area. Am I gonna read this still too quiet, still kind of creepy? Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. This is gonna become the new dot of this game. Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. Oh, I thought this is the break room. I'm dumb. Back in the meeting room. Back out of the meeting room. I don't know, I'm having fun doing this, not gonna lie. Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. Look out the window. And you know what we'll do after the window. The city skyline really is quite beautiful at night. I don't know, today I just have a different voice for some reason. Maybe because I woke up like 1 hour ago. Back to the main office area, let's go! Yep, we're going back here. Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. Okay, let's go, I don't know. Check out that mysterious hallway, okay, I guess there isn't anything to do about it. I guess we didn't see this dialogue yet, so sure. We can always call Cubby if we want to do something. It's the mysterious door. And I'm assuming that... Okay, where is the option to leave? Or go to the closer to the door? Okay, I guess there isn't. But I'm assuming that maybe in the future we're gonna be able to discover someone pressing the passcode here and then call Cubby and go back in time to use this password here or something like that. Or we're gonna go in the door, call Cubby, go back in time and be like, okay, I know the secrets now. We can go through the office without problem. Because there needs to be a reason why it's called an... Find a good time to ask Kinney for help. Yeah, there needs to be a reason for it. And I'm assuming it's not gonna be like, oh no, I'm running out of time. I need to go back. No. It's gonna be something crazy. Because if in the first episode I'm abducted by an alien robot, then yeah. I don't think that there is gonna be a normal reason why I should use her powers. Still too quiet, still kind of creepy. I've never read that line before. Go back to desk. Okay, back at my desk. I don't know, today I cannot make the voice of the main character. It's my to-do list. Let's call Cubby, my android friend. Her abilities might come in handy someday. Oh, one thing that I found really cool. When we're calling Cubby, the text under her name is mobile question mark. Meanwhile, if we call like whiskey, then it's work. Or when we call mother, it's I think like just mobile without anything after. So I think I realized it the first time I played, but I was like, okay, maybe I'm imagining it and it was actually the same mobile question mark for everyone. So yeah, that is pretty cool. Kinney said she could open up another time portal for me. I really could use one right now to go back in time again and start my project earlier. No! Abort the mission! Abort the mission! Hello? Greetings, Earth Penny. Hi, Kinney. I've calculated that you are currently in need of travel to the past in order to gain more time to finish your project. That's right, I want to go back to 3 weeks ago. Should be plenty of time. If you're certain, I will beam down to your location and open a RoboTime Robo Portal for you. You will retain your accumulated knowledge and experience. Thus, you will want to use your time judiciously. Oh, that sounds good. Thus, you will want to use your time judiciously, or you may simply repeat the same pattern you fell into before. I would suggest that you go back in time only once you have gathered much life experience and wisdom. The Robotachion Roboreactor has limited charges. I cannot promise I can send you back again if needed. Just a piece of robo-friendly robot advice. They have enough knowledge and experience. I mean, in any case, I still need more time, right? Yes, go back to 3 weeks ago. No, wait for a better time. On second thought, I think I'll wait for a better time. I concur. How long do you think I need to accumulate life experience for? My project is due the day after tomorrow. Oh, I would say years, Earth Penny. Then again, we Androidians are not bothered by such trivialities as time. What? I don't have that long. Such a primitive creature with such primitive concerns. In any case, Earth Penny, when you are ready, send me a transmission. Yeah. Anyway, I should probably get going then. Thanks. I am robo happy to be of robo service, Earth Penny. Farewell. Well, back to the grind, I guess.
Yeah, what did you expect?
Yeah, I need to finish this project. Let me just go back in time 3 weeks ago. And the robot is like, yeah, you need to have some wisdom. I don't know how about that, bro. I mean, cubby. Okay, action, rest eyes, I guess. I could always call Miss Whiskey, but I'm sure she's just gonna be like, really persuasive for me to be drunk. Which I concur, I really want to do that, but I need to resist temptation from Miss Whiskey. Maybe next week. Rest eyes. I at least got something done tonight. That's pretty good, I guess. I don't think I've done everything I can tonight, though. Maybe I should look at my to-do list again. But it's so late, and I'm just so tired. Okay, let's look at that, I guess. Yeah, I might have missed something. I'll try to force myself to stay awake a little longer. Oh, if I want to rest my eyes, I can always just come back to my desk. Okay, the only thing on my plan is draw advertisement 3, which I'm not quite sure how to do, and find a good time to ask Kinney for help, which isn't related to any plans I have. But I can always save. Yeah, calling Kinney for... Who? Calling Cubby for help isn't a good idea. I at least got something done tonight. That's pretty good, I guess. I don't think I've done everything I can tonight, though. Maybe I should look at my to-do list again, but it's too late. But it's so late and I'm just so tired. Rest eyes. Sorry for reading that so well. You almost didn't realize it was actually me. Rest eyes. I can't go on like this. I'm just going to close my eyes for a bit. Just need to set an alarm or two.
Where the hell am I? Huh? Where am I? Is this a dream? Wait, I can control with... Wait, can I play with my controller? Oh my god! I can play with the controller! No way! Oh, you can even play... Game of the year. It's a rock. Cool. It's a palm tree. Coconuts dangle from the base of its lush fronds adorning the top. Neat! Can I run? Oh my god, it's a... Bactery? It's a bacterium. You know what? I don't think I want to get near it. Rude? Oh, it was... Sir... Bacterium. It's a palm trees. Okay. Neat! Okay, this is the exact music that was playing when... Well, Tiger-chan was on the screen with after being hit by Mr. Koala. It appears to be a measuring stick of some sort. I am a millimeter. You seem a lot taller than a millimeter. Yes, I am more than a millimeter, but I'm also a millimeter. I don't think that's how millimeters work. What? It appears to be a big pile of fluff. A nice soft pile of fluff. I could just roll around in this for hours. Hey, personal space. Yes. Ah, sorry. Oh my god, this place is awesome. The fact that I ended right before it, like, what's going on? I thought today I'm just gonna be like, okay, we fell asleep because that's what happens when you close your eyes for just a second. No, nope. What's going on? It's some kind of brass instrument. Nice. Horn. Okay. I thought there was one more letter after that. I'm just gonna let out a happy toot. Toot. This place is huge though. I thought there was gonna be only Miss Whiskey's tiger form. Also known as my Tiger-chan, the best character ever. That's the only character that's worth drawing. Sorry, I should point at the camera because then it looks more menacing when I'm saying this. The only character worth drawing, or the only character that I'm allowed to draw and be happy in my life. And if you don't draw that only character, then you will be judged. Let me just say that before going to dialogue with someone else, because I really am happy with how fast I'm talking right now. And it's kind of weird for me to be able to talk like this. And normally I'm just slowly talking and hello. A mushroom. What a classy looking mushroom. In fact, I am a mushroom. You mean mushroom? No, I mean mushroom.
Right. Okay, I'm guessing I'm gonna meet... Oh my god, it's me from real life! A sparkling oasis in the desert. Wow, a cool oasis for respite from the harsh desert heat. I ain't a respite. I'm my own oasis. Okay. I'm guessing there's the world with Tigertron, but I cannot see the only character that appeared there. Okay, two characters, because there was also the koala. It's a traffic cone. Why is there a traffic cone here? Everything has a reason, Penny. How do you know my name? It's a present. Whoa, can I open this? Get your grubby mitts off me. Ah. Yeah, beat it, kid. I ain't for you. Okay. What did she say? Can I open this? Get your grubby mitts off me. Ah, it talks. Yeah, beat it, kid. I ain't for you. Okay. Okay, I guess I now understand why is there this walking animation when going through the loading screens. Everything has a reason, Penny. A sad clown. Oh my god, it's me for real. I'm a sad clown. Looking into your sad eyes. It's like looking into my sad soul. It ain't that deep, kiddo. Wait, he actually looks like me. I mean, red eyes. Wait, we don't have red eyes. We normally have, like, orange ones. I wonder if it's Penny for real, then. Okay, so me saying that it's actually me, it's really, really accurate. It's a save icon. Whoa, a save icon. Actually, I'm a floppy diskette. A what? Yeah, that was a good one. I can appreciate that. Yeah, it's kind of weird how that has turned into a freaking save icon. I wonder what game started that. Oh, a flower. It's a flower. It appears to be dancing. That's kind of creepy. Okay, the flower should have been like, Ayo? What do you mean? I'm just a flower. It appears to be an anthropomorphic staple. A staple? I am stapley. It looks like you're trying to escape a dream. Would you like help? I wouldn't say trying to escape. Wow, you're so mad. Okay, that's a good one. Yeah, Staple knows everything that's wrong, don't worry. A large strawberry. Wow, that's a large strawberry with such a manly face. Sir Manly Face Strawberry. I'm Sir Manly Face Strawberry. So descriptive. Tiger House. Wait, but there isn't the koala for real. Huh. It appears to be some kind of sophisticated equipment. Whoa, it's so sophisticated. It's a house. A tiger house. Penny baby, how nice of you to come visit for once. Oh, you're Tiger-chan. Okay, now I definitely know I'm dreaming. I'm happy to see you too, baby. So, you want me to join your little adventure or what? Are you ready to have some fun? Ask Tiger-chan to join. Okay, this is really cool when I'm having a controller, not gonna lie. I mean, sure. Yeah, I could really use a guide. I know this land upside and down, baby. Tiger-chan has joined your party. Oh my god. Can I see her? No, there isn't a party button. It's a house. A tiger house. That's right, this is where I live, baby. So, are you going to invite me in? No. Oh, okay. Rude. Okay, let's see if I have any new dialogue. Whoa, it's so sophisticated. It's my space communications gear, baby. I built it. I like to tinker with this stuff in my spare time. You really built all this? I didn't know you could do that. Yes, you did. Oh, yeah. Right. A large strawberry. Whoa, that's a large strawberry with such a manly face. I'm Sir Manly Face Strawberry. So descriptive. A cool and classy strawberry for sure, baby. Do you have to call me baby 20 times a minute? I wish I could be that cool. It's a palm tree. Coconuts dangle from the base of its lush fronds adorning the top. Neat. Trees are the bee's knees, as they say. They really say that. I mean, Tiger-chan says that, so it's probably true. It appears to be an anthropomorphic staple. A staple? I am Stapley. It looks like you're trying to escape a dream. Would you like help? I wouldn't say trying to escape. Wow, you're so mad. Not a very helpful staple, honestly, baby. Yeah. Hey, yo, what? Oh, here's the little bugger that attacked Tiger-chan before. I don't know, should I go through everything? Like, on one hand, I really want to do that, but on the other, it's like, huh. I'm not quite sure, because it could take a while. It's a save icon. Wow, a save icon. Actually, I'm a floppy diskette. A what? Apparently, they used to use these to store data, baby. You're right. I can hold a whopping 1.44 megabytes. Wow, that's almost half an average JPEG file. Yeah, nowadays I just remind people to save often. In fact, I know someone who lost many hours of work because he didn't save. His text editing software crashed. It was tragic. Oh no, that's so sad. Let's save early and often, baby. Okay, I'm assuming it was a reference to the creator of this game when something bad happened. Relatable. Okay, it's a bacterium. You know what? I don't think I want to get near it. Rude. It's too large to infect you, baby. That just makes it more disgusting. I take offense to that. Same. That's really rude of you. It's a rock. Cool. It looks like these rocks are arranged in a pattern, baby. You're right. There must be a secret hidden somewhere. It appears to be a measuring stick of some sort. I'm a millimeter. You seem a lot taller than a millimeter. Yes, I am more than a millimeter, but I'm also a millimeter. I don't think that's how millimeters work. What? We don't use the metric system here, baby. Then what do you use? We use the millimetric system. The what system? Okay, way too close to way too close to comfort. Oh, wait, I know what I can do. Can you tell me about this place? Oh, okay, I was way too... Maybe I shouldn't be able to control this character. It appears to be a big pile of fluff. A nice, soft pile of fluff. I could just roll around in this for hours. Hey, personal space. Ah, sorry. The fluffs come and go. Sometimes we get a huge number of fluffs migrating through here. It's a real fluff overload, baby. Aww, that sounds cute. It's some kind of brass instrument. Nice. I'm just gonna let out a happy toot. Toot. He can be a pretty noisy neighbor, baby. Yeah, I can imagine. You're not so quiet yourself, Tiger-chan. Toot. Especially when you get bonked. It's Mr. Koala-chan. What? It's Mr. Koala. A mushroom. What a classy looking mushroom. In fact, I am a mushroom. You mean mushroom? No, I mean mushroom. Mushroom, not mushroom. Mushrooms are notable for the powder, baby. Okay, they're what? You betcha. It's a traffic cone. Why is there a traffic cone here? Everything has a reason, Penny. You think it might be marking something? I just love to look out into the sea. If I had legs, I would dance out into the sea. I don't think that's how legs work. Yeah, I don't know how these legs work. Why is there just a tiki, I guess it's called? Oh no, it's... No, it's Suck! It's a little Suck! Oh my god, it's my boy! He grew so much! It's Big Suck now! Oh my god! Okay, I want to talk to you, little Suck. We have so many things to tell each other. It's a present. Whoa, can I open this? Get your grubby mitts off me. Ah, it talks. Yeah, beat it, kid. I ain't for you. Okay. Sometimes you can't judge a present by its wrapper, baby. So profound. A sad clown. I'm a sad clown. Looking into your sad eyes. It's like looking into my sad soul. It ain't that deep, kiddo. Honestly, that clown's a real downer, baby. Yeah. a sparkling oasis in the desert. Whoa, a cool oasis for respite from the harsh desert heat.
I ain't a respite, I'm my own oasis.
Okay. You know, we do have running water at my place, baby. The scale of this place is all weird to me. It's a palm tree. A fluffy koala is relaxing among its lush fronds.
Psst, wait, baby! It's Mr. Koala! Don't get too close to him! He's dangerous!
Him?
He's a malevolent and evil beast, baby!
Really? Are you sure?
Just believe me, baby, okay?
What happened? Leave it alone. Dot dot dot. What happened? Wait, so what happened between you and Mr. Koala?
It was once upon a time.
I had just left my tiger home to play with all my jungle friends, including Mr. Koala, or so I thought.
Okay.
I said hi to Mr. Koala, and he...
What did he do, Tiger-chan?
He dropped a coconut on my head! Bonk! It hurt a lot! He's a monster, baby! Don't talk to him!
That was quite a story.
So what do you think about Mr. Koala, baby? Yeah, just no fear anymore.
Mr. Koala, he's cute actually. I hate him. I hate him. I hate him. He's a terrible koala and he smells bad.
I knew you'd seen my way, baby.
Okay, so what now? Right to battle, as they say.
Wait, to battle? We're battling Mr. Koala?
Of course, baby. His tyranny must end once and for all.
Battle Mr. Koala. Okay.
I'm ready. Let's ride to battle. Alright, baby. Evil will end today. Let me take out my koala-seeking missile. I'll cover you.
Wait, baby. Watch out.
Bonk.
No.
No, baby. No. I feel faint. I see only darkness before me.
No! Mr. Koala, why?
Goodbye, Tiger-chan.
No! No, little sack! I wanted to talk, little sack! What day is it?
What?
Tiger-chan!
Ow, my head! Where am I? Is this the office?
Ah! What time is it?
Sunday.
Crap, it's Sunday night? I slept through the entire day? At my desk? Oh no, this can't be happening. My project is due tomorrow morning. And I didn't get as many project files done as I wanted last night. But if I do my best with my remaining time tonight, I should at least have something to give Miss Whiskey tomorrow. Yeah, solid plan. You can do this, Penny.
I want to go back. I need to talk to Big Sack.
Load.
Go back. I need to go to meet Big Sack. Or Mediocre Sack. I don't know, maybe he's not still a Big Sack.
Holy moly, this dialogue takes forever. Rest eyes. But yeah, that was an exciting adventure.
I did think that meeting Koala could be a mistake, but I didn't expect it to be such a big one.
Wait, let me move up. Oh my god, there's hair animation. That's so interesting. Okay, Tiger-chan, let's go meet Big Sack.
A succulent man glistens and flexes in the bright sun.
Whoa! Could it be? Little Sack? Is that you?
I am Succules. No longer am I little.
Succules? Oh, like Hercules.
I don't know what that is.
You know, like the ancient mythological...
Penny, I am glad to see you. I've been meaning to tell you, Penny.
Oh, what is it?
There's no way to sugarcoat this. I do not want to listen to your constant complaining any longer.
Wait, what?
Every time we meet,
It's always, I don't want to work this. I'm so uninspired that... But I just wanted to talk out my feelings with you. If you had just worked, for even half of the time you spent complaining at me, you'd have finished your project 3 times by now. I can't believe this. It's possibly lack motivation. Go to the gym. Go to the gym. Your gains will keep you motivated. You don't know me at all. I can't believe I'm being treated like this by my closest confidant. Little suck, I trusted you. It's succulent. I raised you, I watered you, and kept you in indirect sunlight. Like it's so hard to water something once every 2 weeks. This body you see before you, it was built with daily hard work and discipline. You cannot wait for inspiration. You must stop whining and start doing. I hate you. You know that I'm right. Yeah, whatever. I don't like him, baby. Want me to rip his throat out? No, it's okay? Tiger-chan, I really related that you say something like that. But no, little suck. Even when he broke my heart, he's fine to be. He's a perfect little boy. I don't want to lose him. Okay, so what do we have to do? Broken.